start with the second day of the seminar. We will be resuming with the today's whatever presentations are there. We have the first presentation by Dr. Mansoor Ali. Can we have it, sir? Yes. Dr. Mansoor Ali is an associate professor, government from Medical College, Calicut. He took his BHMS and MD in preparatory from Government Homoeopathic Medical College, Calicut, and appointed by the Kerala government in the same college in the Department of Preparatory. He is the director and chief editor of the largest website of homoeopathic education, www.similia.com. He has edited and presented papers in various state, national and international conferences. He has conducted various workshops and training programs for BHMS students, interns, government medical officers, teachers and practitioners. He is also a visiting lecturer to many homeopathic institutes and universities. He is a leading practitioner in Calicut and first rank holder in MBA entrance examination and Kerala Public Service Commission examination for the post of lecturer. He is also the member of PG Board of Studies, Kerala University of Health Sciences. He is a member of UG Board of Studies to Kerala University of Health Sciences and a member of UG Board of Studies, Calicut University. We are honored to have you, sir. Please. I request Dr. Mansoor Ali, please take now to the Dr. Thank you, sir.
At the outset, I would like to thank the organizers for inviting me to share some ideas with you. So in the next 1 hour and 15 minutes, I would like to discuss something about the homoeopathic approach in the rheumatological disorders. Give a man a fish, you feed him for a day. Teach a man to fish, you feed him for a lifetime. So the second one, that is what we are going to discuss, how to fish, rather than giving some clinical tips, improve our private practice with a very high success rate and also the research in homeopathy. So how to fish? There are nearly more than 100 types of rheumatic disorders, from ankylosing spondylitis to arthritis in children to vasculitis, viral arthritis, and vulgaris granulomatosis. It's a very vast topic. And according to Wikipedia, the major rheumatic disorders are ankylosing spondylitis, back pain, bursitis or tendinitis, capsulitis, neck pain, osteoarthritis, and osteoporosis. These are the major rheumatological disorders. So I would like to concentrate on two aspects. That is first one, that is on osteoporosis. Second one, back pain, a very common condition. Then we will discuss something about the importance of location, importance of accessory management, something about the effective rubric selection, followed by the philosophic aspect of the homeopathic approach in rheumatological disorders. So one of the most important basic requirement for the best result in homeopathy, our case taking should be perfect. If we neglect making a careful case taking, the patient will be the first sufferer. And at the end, you yourself will suffer from it. That means we will lose a lot of patients. And ultimately, the people will blame homeopathy. So that is something peculiar about the homeopathy. Even though we have good knowledge in the repertory, materia medica, practice of medicine, whatever it may be, if our case taking is defective, we will never get the desired result. So always remember, one of the basic requirements for getting the best result, our case taking should be perfect. And this is very true in the case of the rheumatological disorders and also the neurospinal disorders that we are going to discuss. So we'll start with the osteoporosis. And I would like to discuss only the nutshell points. So, I think that may be useful in our day-to-day practice. So we can osteoporosis, homoeopathic approach. So what is osteoporosis? That means a porous bone. A low bone mass and deterioration of the bone tissue. That leads to increased risk of bone fractures. That's one of the main complications of the osteoporosis. Bone fractures. Especially in the wrist, hip and the spine. These are the three major areas. Wrist, hip and spine. Vulnerable to fracture. So this is a section showing the osteoporosis. This is the normal bone and this is the osteoporotic bone. Great difference. Normal bone and the osteoporotic bone. So the purpose of this homoeopathic treatment. Homoeopathic remedies will allow the essential minerals and nutrients to be absorbed more efficiently. That I will justify with some research findings. So thus preventing the bone fractures or accelerating the healing of any existing bone fracture. So the first point, that will allow the essential minerals to be absorbed effectively and preventing the bone fractures or accelerating the healing of any existing fractures. Now the methodology of homeopathic treatment. The homeopathic remedies will not reverse the existing bone loss. We can't change the bone of a 70 years old into a 20 years old. It's not possible. We can't reverse the existing bone loss of aging, but it can help to control the pain, will slow down or stop further bone loss. We can control the disability. We can control the pain and also the further bone loss and can promote the stability and healing. So that is a methodology in homeopathic treatment. We can't reverse, but we can prevent the disability. So the aim and objective of homeopathic management that can be achieved easily by the first point, that is that dietary intake of calcium. That's the correction. Dietary intake of calcium. Correction of the intestinal absorption of calcium. And third, correction of the assimilation of calcium channels in body by the constitutional homeopathic remedies. Correction of the assimilation. Then exercise in the form of the light exercise and or meditation and the therapeutic correction. So these are the aims and objectives of homeopathic treatment that can be achieved by these methods. And the line of treatment. The line of treatment that also depend on the cause of the osteoporosis. Line of treatment depend on the cause of the osteoporosis. So the most common form is primary of osteoporosis is due to age. The most common form that is due to age. Therefore, corrected by the dietary intake of calcium or supplementation, and we can use the our homeopathic remedies. And the second one, osteoporosis resulting from inflammatory conditions of the GIT or joints, like the tubercular arthritis or vasculitis or inflammatory bowel diseases. So, osteoporosis resulting from inflammatory conditions of GIT or joints that can be managed by we have a group of remedies, especially the calcium nitrate. Phytolaka, the main point is especially the psoriasis associated with the joint complaint. It's a very good remedy. Then acid absorbic nitric acid, etc. And I am not going to elaborate a lot of therapeutics, but we have to discuss the methodology. And the rubrics. You can note it down if you care. These are the main rubrics for the osteoporosis in the synthesis repertorium, homeopathicum, syntheticum. The first one that is extremities, osteoporosis, borium, purum, cortisone, dysentery, and microbacteria are the remedies. Then generalis osteoporosis, that's another rubric. Generalis osteoporosis, if the lesion is on the multiple sides. Otherwise, we can take it as extremities. Then generalis brittle bone, generalis softening of the bone. Service called as the osteomalacia. Then generalis bone complaints. These are the main rubric for the osteoporosis. That's, this condition is nowadays very common in synthesis repertoire. And in the Murphy's repertory, the rubrics are generalis osteoporosis. Then in the chapter extremities osteoporosis, then there is a chapter clinically. The rubric decalcification of bones, calcarea, calcarea pruritica, calcarea post, corallium, rubrum, etc. So these are the three main rubrics in this Murphy's repertory. That is extremities osteoporosis, generalis osteoporosis, and the clinical decalcification of bone. Now I would like some research findings. Since this institute is basically concentrating on the research, we have to discuss something on the research aspects of the homeopathy. Osteoporosis with the homeopathy. This is very interesting. Comparative therapeutic you some result on it. And calcarea phosphorica, that is allopathy versus homeopathy. In bone repair of the gastrite and rats. And this was the Department of Bioscience and Oral Diagnosis, Sao Paulo State University. And the aim of this work, was to study the effect of resetronate, that's an allopathic medicine, and calcarea phosphorica, 6th CS, homeopathic medicine, on the repair of bone lesion in male rats with osteoporosis induced by castration. 84 3-month-old rats were used and divided into 4 groups of 21 animals each. So total 84 rats divided into 4 groups of 21 animals each. 3 groups were castrated and 1 group was submitted to sham surgery. So what is it by sham surgery? It's a placebo surgery. They will give anesthesia, preoperative care and postoperative care, but no incision. Like the placebo treatment. So sham surgery. 1 month later, the cortical lesions were made in all animals' tibia, and after 1 day, the different experimental treatment began according to the following groups. That is the CR means castrated, and used resetronate 1 mg per kg per day. CCP castrated, that is calcarea phosphorica, 6 CH, 3 drops per daily. Then calcarea CP means castrated with the bar and used placebo, SP, sham surgery. That's one placebo. These are all the groups. And these animals were sacrificed at 7, 14 and 28 days. 7, 14 and 28 days. After the beginning of the treatment and at the tibia removed, digital radiograph of the tibia were taken and analyzed in order to evaluate the optical density of the defect area. Digital radiograph. Then they were decalcified and processed for histological and histomorphometrical analysis. Now see the results. The data was submitted to ANOVA and took a direct test. These are some of the basic statistical tests. The resetronate treatment influenced the repair, leading to greater bone quantity than induced with the calcarea phosphorica. But see the next. However, the bone formed under the resetronate treatment displayed a resistance to resorption. Keeping its trabecular aspect, while calcarea phosphorica 6th CS bone changed from an initially trabecular to a lamellar bone at the end of the experiment. From trabecular to lamellar. So, homeopathic medicines are comparatively good effect in osteoporosis, and the further research is necessary to assess the resistance and quality of the newly formed bone. So, this is the first research. Then, second one, osteogenesis in vitro in rat tibia. Derived osteoblasts is promoted by the homeopathic preparation FMS calcarea chlorica, calcium chloride, FMS calcarea chlorica, that's the preparation. That is from the genetics of the Department of Oncology, University of Geneva, Italy. They studied the effect of in vitro treatment of differentiating the osteogenic cells with FMS calcarea chloride to determine whether it is causing any changes in the proliferative or differentiation of the potential of the osteoblasts. So that's their test. In the FMS calcarea flow. FMS calcium flow was developed for the therapy of the postmenopausal and age-related osteoporosis on the basis of the principles of homeopathy by that university. Alkaline phosphatase activity and levels of alkaline phosphatase and mRNA were increased by the treatment with the FMS calcium flow. So we can control the calcium channels. Alkaline phosphatase activity and levels of alkaline phosphatase and mRNA were increased by the treatment with the FMS calcarea fluid. And incorporation of the radial labeled calcium into the matrix was also increased, and the formation of nodules occurred in shorter time and with higher frequency than in untreated controls. So that is another explanation. Then third one, from the Journal of American Medical Association. A major clinical trial published in the Journal of the American Medical Association showed the woman on hormone replacement therapy. Always remember, nowadays this osteoporosis is very common because of this hormone treatment. Hormone replacement therapy for various ailments like menopause, infertility and PCOD were at high risk of breast cancer, heart disease and osteoporosis than those using the homeopathy for the same complaints. That's the result is published in this, Journal of American Medical Association. Then another one, effect of homeopathic calcium on bone density by the Karina Harkin. It's another pilot study. This pilot study aimed at exploring the effect of medium potency calcium on the bone density of women over a period of 1 year. over a period of 1 year. The majority of the women were positive menopause. The bone density was measured before and after the treatment with the bone ultrasonometry. They measured the bone density. The result showed that the medium potency calculator curve was an increase in the bone density of 11 of 15 participants. That's why we can arrest the further progress of the osteoporosis. So 10 of these are positive menopause. This prescription can be conveyed safely with the conventional drugs and it is very cost effective or medium potency of calcarea carbonic. It is concluded that this homoeopathic dose may be viable. It's a very good treatment for the osteoporosis and theme of the study, theme medical, source of the study that the theme medical publishes. So another one case of osteoporosis recently treated, just to compare the head of the curve on both sides. Right? This is right side, left side. Osteoporosis with some bone fractures. We took this following rubric, mind in hurry, extremities cracked in the skin, toes between, perspiration stain in the linen yellow, extremities pain hips, right, extremities pain hip, rising sitting from other ways, then extremities osteoporosis, and lastly one rubric from the Murphy's repertoire, that's from the chapter toxicity, that is hormone poisoning ailments from contraceptives. That's the main reason for osteoporosis. Right is only 47. Just see a point. Head of the hormone. This much of osteoporosis because of the hormone treatment for the infertility. That ultimately resulted in osteoporosis. And we have started the treatment with the cortisone. And from our experience, cortisone is a very good remedy to start treatment with the, if the patient is already on hormone treatment or the steroids. So you see the, some of the rubrics for related osteoporosis, I mean this cortisol. There is a rubric that is in the chapter, then royalties. Laboratory investigation, that's a beautiful rubric. That's in synthesis laboratory. The royalties laboratory findings. Creatinine increase, it's a very good remedy, that's the cortisol. Usually start the treatment with the cortisol. And see in the extremities, there's a look at the osteoporosis. Again, what is one effect? Remedy, said what a remedy for the osteoporosis. And there is a rubric in Murphy's repertory. That's in the chapter toxicity. Hormone poisoning ailments from that is from contraceptive hormone replacement therapy. Again, cortisone and corticosteroid are the some of the important properties. So from our experience, it is better to start with it. If the patient is already under steroids, one hormone therapy, it's better to start with cortisone. And after that, let's give a constitutional remedy, that is an anti-hormonum and repeated that is 1-12-8, and we are waiting for an X-ray after 3 months. Now almost all the complaints, physical complaint, the symptomatic relief, but we are expecting some changes in the X-ray also. So conclusion of this, something about osteoporosis, that homeopathy provides effective remedies that not only help to prevent the disease, but also to minimize. And it is safe, economical, and gentle way to tackle the osteoporosis. It works both to help the osteoporosis and prevent further nutritional deficiency. That can prevent further nutritional deficiency. That is helping the assimilation or the correction of the calcium channels. And these are all the reference for this osteoporosis from various journals. Now I would like to discuss the second part, back pain. As I said earlier, I would like to concentrate on two topics, that is first one osteoporosis and the second one back pain. That is very common also. And it is very easy to manage also. But you must have some methodology or protocols. First we'll discuss something about the LS spine disorders, lumbar spine disorders. So lumbar spondylosis, that is also nowadays very common. That means a degenerative condition which affects the lower spine. So the main pathology, narrowing of the space between the vertebrae, causing a variety of health problems ranging from back pain to neurological issues. because of the narrowing of the space between the vertebrae. That is the main pathology. This is called as the osteoarthrosis of the spine. Lumbar spondylosis means osteoarthritis or osteoarthrosis. So it is better to call as osteoarthrosis than osteoarthritis. That's it. It's not. So development of the bone spurs and bony overgrowth. That's the main pathology. Development of the bone spurs and bony overgrowth around the spine, which can pinch the nerves. That ultimately leads to narrowing of the spinal canal, which can cause poor bladder control and unsteady gait. And always remember, in the case of the lumbar spondylosis and IBDP, the patient might have poor bladder control and also constipation. So that's a common symptom of that disease. It's a disease symptom. So it is better to avoid take rubrics like the constipation or the bladder control, etc. Because that's a disease symptom or the clinical symptom. So which can cause poor bladder control and unsteady gait. So just see, this is a normal spine, vertebral body with intervertebral disc. L5, S1 disc, that's between L4 and then L4, L5 disc. It's a normal MRI of the spine, L4, L5 disc, and L5, S1 disc. That's between 2 points, vertebrae. So, a disc. Disc is a fibrocartilaginous cushion between all the vertebrae except between the first two. That is also usually asking for the comparative examinations like the PGM and some EPS. Except between the first two. The fibrocartilaginous cushion. So it's about L4, then L5, so this is the disc. So with a single slide, it's very easy to identify the lumbar spondylosis. So it's a normal vertebrae, normal intervertebral disc. So bones for